All right, let's get started by creating your very first room. So if you go to gobrunch.com/main, it is going to take you to this page right here. And over to the right, you can see the account button. If you click on that, it's going to show you your account. It is going to show you your profile. That's where you can upload your profile photo, get all of your name and information all set up in that profile. So I came over here to create, and we are going to pick a room to create. Now, I normally just use a co-working space, a classroom, an event, something like that. Today, we're just going to use the co-working. So you click Get Started, and then you name it. Now, remember, you can always rename this, but go ahead and put a name onto it. So I am going to call this First Room. Now, I'm going to click Next. Now, this asks if I want to enable a secret key. I always push no right here. You can always add one later, but I find it best practices to say no. Now, this page right here says, would you like to collect registrations? Now, if you click yes here, people are going to have to register when they enter. Now, in my opinion, I always click no here because you can still get people's registrations. And if you click yes at the time that I recorded this, that page is a little bit confusing for people that have never been to a GoBrunch platform before. So if you're inviting people to an event or something like that, and they're not GoBrunch users already, this could be a bit confusing. So my best practice is I always click no. Now, you are welcome to click yes. You are welcome to do any of the things you want to do. So this asks me how many additional rooms I want. Now, I usually create several rooms, but when I'm starting, I maybe just click one. And the reason is I usually make these rooms a little bit different, so it doesn't really matter. You can always add rooms, subtract rooms. So all of these preliminary things that you're choosing, don't put too much thought into it. Don't let this stumble you. You can change everything. So it is saying, what kind of a room do I want to create? Well, maybe I just want to create a really nice room for a meeting. Oh, this is nice. Let's click this one. Okay, and then we click create. Now, first room is created here. So now I'm going to click on that so that I can enter that room. Here we are. So this is where all the fun begins. I'm going to move this video of me over here so it's out of the way. Now, this is where all the fun begins because now you get to start creating your room. So the first thing we're going to do is go into room settings. Now, this is where you set up how your room, all the things that happen in your room. I personally like auto seating because, again, when people are not familiar with GoBrunch, they may not understand how to seat themselves. So these are choices that you have to make. For me, I always click auto seat. Now, do you want people in your room to have access to a mic? For me, I always do because I'm a talker and I want people to talk to me. Now, does everyone have access to their cam? Now, this question here is actually talking about their circle cam, and that is just the small camera that appears in the circle. So you can say yes or no. Now, this is access to the presenter cam. Now, the presenter cam is the big square cam that shows up. So do you want people to be able to have access to that? Now, for me, when I'm on in small meetings, one-on-one meetings, or a group of four or five, I love to have that presenter cam because I like to see people bigger. But if I'm doing a huge event or a workshop or something like that, I want people to have access to their circle cam, but I don't want them to be able to put their presenter cam on because it gets too cluttered. And I only want the people that are actually presenting, whether it's me or a guest or two or three people. I only want specific people to have that presenter cam. So for me, I'm going to click yes just because this room that I'm making now is more of a little a little room maybe for, you know, a one-on-one meeting or maybe a small group meeting. So I'm going to say yes here. Now it says, does everyone have access to share their screen? Depending on what you're doing, do you want, is this a collaboration thing where you want people to share their screen or not? You can choose that. Now, this is pretty important. This is, do you want their mics enabled when they come into the room? In other words, as soon as they come into the room, do you want them to be able to just talk, or do you want them to have to go down to the bottom and click unmute? Probably in most circumstances, it's best to not have that mic open because some people don't know and they'll come in with maybe background noise or other things going on. So test your mic. I always leave that on. Join notification. It gives you a little pop when somebody comes in. It's not super annoying, but it is a little click. I like to know when people are coming in. Bad word filter. I personally don't need that. Now, this says a date, no date or time notification. Now, if you are having an event that starts at 10 o'clock, you might want to turn this on, and you do that by clicking that and coming over here, and it says, when does this date start? When does this date, what time and what day and time does it end? Now, the reason for that is if you're expecting a big group of people, maybe some people are going to come in a little bit early and they're going to think, what's going on? No one's here. So if you have that notification up, they'll know, oh, okay, I'm actually in the wrong time zone. I'm an hour earlier. I'm an hour, you know, whatever. So that's a really good reason why you would use that feature. And then save public chat history. Now, if you click save the public chat history, then as people come and go, when they come back in, they're going to see all of the chat history until you clear it out. So, I mean, it could be from 3 days ago. It could be, you know, just from the beginning of the meeting or whatever. So that is, again, personal choice. Do you want that, or do you want to do it? If you unclick it, then when people leave, they come back and they just start the chat, seeing the chat as to when they came in. So those are the things that you need to think about when you are doing this. Now, let's say I was like, oh my gosh, I actually don't want that background that it picked. I actually want a different background. This is when you can change that. Now, remember, once you start building your room out, if you change this layout, you're going to erase all the changes that you made. So I always suggest that you're pretty sure before you get started what layout you want. But let's say that was a really cute thing, but I actually want to do something else. I'm going to make this just a chill room. All right. And oh, I almost forgot. Now, dynamic mode and presentation mode give you a very different look. I'm actually going to show you this later, but I want to show you where this is. Now, each person, as they come in, they can change the view no matter what, but this is how it's going to be default. So when someone walks in, this is what they're going to get. And then if they don't like it, they want to change it, they're welcome to change it. So I'm going to leave this on dynamic mode because personally, and that's my favorite. And then I'm going to hit update. There we go. Now we have this room and we are ready to get started. So we're going to go back to this room again, but instead of going to room settings, we are going to go to a background editor. Now, this is where all the magic happens. First of all, you can change the size of your circles. Maybe, here we go, extra large. Ooh, those are really, really large, right? That's pretty large. I don't want them that big. So let's go down here to medium. And there is the size they were to begin with. And let's go here to small. Now, if you have these small ones, obviously you can fit more people in here. Now, how do you get more circles? A couple different ways. You can do add circle, just like that, or you can click on the circle and click duplicate. Now, why one versus the other? Well, because maybe I have changed the color of my circle and it matters to me which one goes where. So again, if you click on this, you can go to color. You can click on this and you can either change the color through this or you can click that little eyedropper and get a color and then click OK. Now my circle is more matching to this. Now maybe I want this circle to match the wall a little bit better. All right, there, now we've got this circle here. Now, maybe I just want to delete these. And then I want to just copy, duplicate the ones that they're the right color that I want right here. And you know I'm going to have a group of people in here, so I'm going to add these here like that. All right. So these are some very basic things you can do. Now, you can also add a logo, a picture, or something like that. So let's go over here. I did not think about what I was going to add here. I'm going to add a camera. Now, this obviously doesn't really go with this room, but I just wanted to show you how to add something and I forgot to prepare something. So if you want to resize this, what you're going to do is click your shift button, grab this here, and then you can shrink that up like that. I'm going to put this crazy camera right here on the shelf, just to kind of show you how that works. Now, you can add your logo to your business. Maybe you want to add something to go in here. Now, then all you have to do is hit save. Now, when you do have something like this that you've added your thing to, when you click on it or when somebody in the room clicks on it, it gets big. And that's just kind of a cool little thing. So if you have maybe a poster or something like that that you've put in here and you want it to get, you know, they can't really read it when they see it because it's small. When they click on it, it is going to expand for them. And you also, you can take out these GoBrunch logos and replace them with something that you want or leave it completely blank. Now, the other things, I just want to show you a few more things, and that is the view. So if you go to down to my view, there is dynamic view, which is what we set as the default, and there is presentation mode. Now, presentation mode looks like this. So when they come in, they see all of the room and then the chat goes right here, chat right here. So the chat's gonna be all along this wall. So maybe if you're doing like a workshop or a group thing where people are really putting a lot of information in the chats, this might be a better option. The other thing that's going to happen here in the presentation mode is if you share your screen or you turn on your camera, all of that is going to go on top. So if you share your screen, if you have a slideshow or something to show, it's going to go all up here in the top and they can find it that way. Now, if you are in dynamic mode, then everything that you share is going to show up on top of this. And everyone, including you, can make that camera big. And that goes for a shared screen or anything else. Make it small, shove it over to the side, do whatever you want. One of the coolest features about GoBrunch is the fact that everyone has autonomy over their experience here. So you can put the cameras where you want, people can put the cameras where they want, and it doesn't affect that. Now, the other thing, just super simple, when you're in here, you can jump from circle to circle. You know, if maybe your guest comes in and they sit over here, you want to go sit beside them. However it is, you are welcome to do that. The other thing I don't want to forget to show you is on the dynamic mode, your chats are right here in this box. And this chat box can also be moved. It can be shrunk down. So this is where all of these things go.